Hello everyone, today we will be studying conditional distribution of multivariate normal vector. So what I mean by this is, if I have a vector y which is following normal distribution, p variate normal distribution with mean mu and variance covariance matrix sigma, let me have y1 as a sub vector which is of order k cross 1, and y2 is a subvector which is of order r cross 1, such that my y is actually y1, y2. So in this case, we will try to find distribution of y2 given y1. Okay, so we are interested in finding distribution of y2 given y1. So, where is this needed? First of all, you are all familiar with the regression setup where you might have something like x1, x2, xp as regressors, and then y is your response. This happens in your usual multiple linear regression setup. In such case, when you try to predict y using values of x1, x2, xp, you know that your prediction is actually expectation of y given x1, x2, xp, assuming that there is a linear relationship. So what you need is actually the conditional distribution of y given x1, x2, xp. If I want to go for multiple response scenario, then I would need this. So if I know that all my components are normal and the joint distribution is also normal, and if I want to predict few components using knowledge about some other components, then I am going to need conditional distribution of y2 given y1. So we will try to derive that today. What we know about conditional distribution so far is, your conditional distribution is actually joint upon marginal. This we have been using since BSc first year. So if I want to extend the same result here, I can write PDF of y2 given y1 is same as PDF of joint PDF of y1, y2 would actually be PDF of vector y upon PDF of y1. We know that y1 is, yesterday we saw the subvector, distribution of a subvector. So y1 will be k variate normal with mean mu1, variance covariance matrix sigma 11. Okay, so this we know. So if I try to use this, what I am going to get is conditional PDF of y2 given y1 will actually be this PDF of np mu sigma divided by PDF of nk mu1 sigma 11. Okay, the conditional PDF, I will have this formula. So we can try to substitute. So the numerator over here is f of vector y equal to small y. So this we know is going to be 1 upon 2 pi raised to p by 2, determinant of sigma raised to half, and then e raised to minus half y minus mu prime sigma inverse y minus mu. Okay, whereas my denominator is going to be f of y1 equal to y1, so this will be 1 upon 2 pi raised to k by 2 determinant of sigma 1 raised to half e raised to minus half y1 minus mu 1 prime sigma 1 inverse y1 minus mu 1. So if I try to take the ratio, my 2 pi raised to p by 2 and 2 pi raised to k by 2 is going to get adjusted to give me 2 pi raised to r by 2, which makes sense that the conditional distortion will also have a 2 pi component, but the power will be same as the order of this y2 whose distortion we are trying to find. What we need is we need relationship between determinant of sigma and determinant of sigma 1 1. This is what we need, relationship between these two, so that we know what to cancel. And we also need relationship between sigma inverse and sigma 1 1 inverse, where we know that my sigma is actually partitioned as sigma 1 1, sigma 1 2, sigma 2 1, and sigma 2 2. So what we need is properties of determinants of partitioned matrices, and we also need formulae for inverses of partitioned matrices. So basically inverses and determinants of partitioned matrices, they are going to help us to solve these things and check what gets cancelled, what doesn't get cancelled, and so on. Since all of you have studied linear algebra, I would say refer to your linear algebra notes, or there is a book by C.R. Rao on linear statistical inference, so that can also help you in getting these required properties. Okay, so using these, homework is find a conditional distribution. Of course, don't worry, I am not going to leave the entire thing for you. This is one way of proving the things. So this is your usual way, the joint PDF upon marginal PDF. So that we are trying to do here. But we will try to derive one proof here in the lecture by using some other method. Okay, so we are going to find conditional distribution, don't worry. But we won't use the traditional method, we would use some other method. So we'll try to find conditional distribution of y2 given y1. So for that, let us try to define a new vector w. Okay, so let w be defined as some matrix g times y minus mu. Okay, let vector w be defined as some matrix g times y minus mu. And I am going to define G as identity matrix, zero matrix, then some other matrix minus A, and again identity matrix. You will very soon realize why I am taking this particular relationship, this particular G and so on. Just give me some minutes. Where the orders are, this is K cross K, this is R cross R. So this is K cross R and this is R cross K. No, there is some problem. Wait. If my I is going to be K cross K, then my R columns are left. So this is K cross R, this is R cross K, this is R cross R. Okay. Okay, so if I use this G, then what is W? So my W is actually I 0 minus A I into, because now I want things to be compatible with this partition, I would write my Y as Y1 and mu as mu 1 and then Y2 minus mu 2. This we know is K cross 1. This we know is R cross 1. So now I can multiply this by this, this by this. So what do I get? Now I into this plus 0 into this. So my first entry remains y1 minus mu1. And then I into this and minus a into this. So I have minus a times y1 minus mu1 plus I into, so just y2 minus mu2. Okay, minus a into y1 minus mu1. A is r cross k, this is k cross 1, so the product is compatible. And this is again r cross 1. So we are fine. Now, what I have is w, and let me call these as say w1 and this as say w2. So if this is my w1 and if this is my w2, then can I say something about distribution of w? From yesterday's properties of multivariate normal random vector, what we know is w will also have normal distribution, again p variate normal distribution, because this is k cross 1, this is r cross 1, so the addition is p cross 1. But the mean vector would be g times mean of this. So mean of this is y1 minus mu1, y2 minus mu2, means mean of this is 0. So mean is actually a 0 vector. And variance covariance will be g sigma g prime. Okay. Because my variance is not going to get affected by these shifts of origin, my variance would simply be variance of y. So I have g sigma g prime. Now what is g sigma g prime? Let us try to compute. So g sigma g prime, g I know is I 0 minus a I. Sigma I would again write in the partitioned form so that I can take the product of partitioned matrices. Sigma 1 1, sigma 1 2, sigma 2 1, sigma 2 2. And g prime is going to be I prime, which is I, then minus A prime here, 0 prime, again I can write as 0, and this I prime I can write as I. Okay. So I have minus I minus A prime, 0 I. So this becomes, let me take the product. So I into sigma 1 1, this is gone. So sigma 1 1, then I into sigma 1 2, this is gone with 0. So sigma 1 2. Minus a into sigma 1 1 and I into sigma 2 1. So I have sigma 2 1 minus a sigma 1 1. And last entry is minus a sigma 1 2 and then sigma 2 2. So sigma 2 2 minus I sigma 1 2 actually. Sorry. Minus a sigma 1 2 plus sigma 2 2. So minus a sigma 1 2. And this is I minus a prime 0 I. So what do I get? Sigma 1 1 into I, sigma 1 2 into 0. So I still have sigma 1 1 here. Then sigma 1 1 minus a prime sigma 1 2 into I. So sigma 1 2 minus sigma 1 1 a prime. Then the entry over here is going to be this into I plus this into 0. So basically the same. So sigma 2 1 minus a sigma 1 1. And the last entry, let me call it for the time being sigma 2 2 dot 1. We will try to see what it will be. So sigma 2 2 dot 1 is actually going to be, let us go back. So it is going to be this into this. So sigma 2 2 minus a sigma 1. So I want final entry, right? So it is going to be this into a prime and then this into I. So this will remain as it is. So sigma 2 1 minus a prime. So let me write minus sigma 21 a prime. Then next part is minus a sigma 11 a prime. So minus minus will become plus. So plus a sigma 11 a prime. Then next term is going to be this into I. So just sigma 22 minus a sigma 12. So plus sigma 22 minus a sigma 12. Okay. So right now I don't know what this is. Let me keep it as it is. This is my distribution of W. Now, right now, I know that covariance term, we can just check whether this is a variance covariance matrix. So this sigma 12 minus sigma 11 a prime, if I take transpose of this, it becomes sigma 21 minus a sigma 11, because sigma 11 is symmetric. So this is transpose of this. So that property of covariance matrix is satisfied. Ideally, if suppose this were to become 0, then my life is easy. Because if this becomes 0, then I would have covariance to be 0. Let me write what I am trying to say. So, covariance of W1, W2 would be 0 if and only if that matrix is 0. That matrix is sigma 1. Let me take the denominator thing. So, sigma 21 minus a sigma 11. If and only if sigma 21 minus a sigma 11 is 0. Okay, sigma 21 minus a sigma 11 is 0. Now, what is the benefit of getting this? What I know is vector W follows p variate normal with some mean and some variance covariance matrix. That much I know. So, this means that W1 and W2 have joint normal distribution. We also know that covariance is 0. So from yesterday's property, this would imply W1 and W2 are independent. Of course, if the covariance is 0. So if and only if sigma 21 minus a sigma 11 is equal to 0. What does this mean? This means that if I choose my A matrix wisely, I can make my covariance to be 0. That would make the two components independent. And if the components are independent, then I know that from getting, you know, marginal distribution is easy, because conditional and marginal are actually same for independent components. So, therefore, this would imply that W1 and W2, okay, let me write in the form. So this would imply that conditional distribution of W2 given W1 will be same as marginal distribution. So I won't need a different derivation. It will be same as the marginal distribution of W2. Of course, if covariance between W1, W2 is 0. So far, we don't know whether covariance is 0. Now, to make covariance 0, we need this to be 0. So, this can be achieved by choosing A appropriately. Appropriate A. Appropriate means what? I want sigma 21 minus a sigma 11 to be 0. So my sigma 21 should be equal to a sigma 11. Sigma 11 is going to be non-singular. So my a should actually be sigma 11 inverse. No, wait. It's matrix multiplication. So I can post multiply by sigma 11 inverse. So I'll have sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse is equal to A. I'll multiply by sigma 11 inverse, so it becomes identity matrix. So with this choice of A, I can make the components independent and my life would be easy. So let us use that. So if A is equal to sigma 21, sigma 11 inverse, then what happens? Then my sigma 22.1, which was here, so let me give a number star here. So from star, what do I get? I get sigma 22.1 as minus sigma 21 A prime. A prime will be sigma 11 inverse sigma 12 plus A is sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse. Then I have sigma 11 and A prime is again sigma 11 inverse sigma 12 plus sigma 22, I'll keep as it is, minus A. So A I will substitute again as sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse sigma 12. Okay, this term was minus. Fine. So what do I have? Minus sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse sigma 12. This is also with minus sign. This sigma 11 inverse will become I. So I have sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse sigma 12. So basically this and this, all three terms are actually same. 2 minus signs, 1 plus sign. So I am left with sigma 22 minus sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse sigma 12. Okay, so this is nothing but variance of W2. Okay, this is marginal variance of W2. What we were saying is, by this choice of A, my conditional distribution and marginal distribution are going to be the same. Therefore, variance of W2 given W1 will also be this same, sigma 22.1. Okay. Mean is anyway 0. So expectation of W2 given W1 is anyway a 0 vector. Now what is W2 and what is W1? So my W1 is Y1 minus mu 1 and my W2 is this. So let me substitute A here. So W2 is actually Y2 minus mu 2 minus A times Y1 minus mu 1. So it is Y2 minus mu 2 minus A times Y1 minus mu 1. What is my A? Let me substitute that. So it is Y2 minus mu 2 minus A is sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse Y1 minus mu 1. So this is actually same as okay, let me write it as it is right now. So Y2 minus mu 2 minus sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse Y1 minus mu 1. We are saying that, and what is my W1? W1 is Y1 minus mu 1. So we are saying that conditional distribution of W2 given W1 is same as marginal distribution of W2. If it is conditional, means if W1 is known, then this component becomes known. Okay. Further, these are anyway constants. So this entire thing becomes known if we are conditioning on W1. So if it is known, then we would know that mean of if I want conditional expectation of y2 minus mu2 given y1 minus mu1, one more point, y1 minus mu1, knowing y1 minus mu1 is same as knowing y1, because mu1 is anyway a constant, so it is not random, so it is kind of known. So this is same as expectation of w2, okay, expectation of w2, and this I will shift to this side because anyway it is constant, plus sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse y1 minus mu1. Okay, expectation of w2 I know it's 0. These expectations, conditional expectation of this, sorry, of course this is conditioned on y1 minus mu1, so this is 0, this is constant, so I don't need expectation here. So expectation of y2 minus mu2 given y1 is same as this second term, that is sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse y1 minus mu1, and hence expectation of y2 given y1, I'll shift mu2 also, would become mu2 plus sigma 21 sigma 11 inverse y1 minus mu1. Okay, this is expectation, and variance of y2 given y1 will actually be same as variance of w2 given w1. Why? Because the difference between w2 and y2, difference between w2 and y2 are just these terms which are anyway constant or known if we are conditioning. Okay, therefore variance of y2 given y1 is same as variance of w2 given w1, which is sigma 22.1. Hence my final conclusion is distribution of y2 given y1 is actually r variate normal with mean, let me call this something, so let me give a name to this as say mu 22.1. okay, so with mean mu 22.1 and variance sigma 22.1. okay, from where this 22.1 comes in sigma, it may be easy for you to see here. Let me show you what is sigma 22.1. sigma 22.1, so it is sigma 22 21 11 inverse 12, so 22.1, so 1 is kind of in between. Okay, so this is conditional distribution. Now where do we use it? So one obvious use is for predicting if parts of the part of the information is known. Means, for example, if I know say age of a person and height of a person, can I predict say weight and BP? So in that case my y2 would become weight and blood pressure, let us say systolic blood pressure, and y1 will become age and height. So using age height, can I predict this? In the bivariate case, you have seen this form for conditional distribution. So if we actually try to write down the form for bivariate case, it is quite easy. You have already seen it, but let me revise it here. So in the bivariate case, my formula for distribution of x2, let me call y2 given y1, is going to have normal distribution with mean mu1 plus sigma 21 upon sigma 11 x1 minus mu1 and sigma 22.1, where sigma 22.1 is actually sigma 22 into 1 minus rho square. Homework is try to derive this using the multivariate version. Derive bivariate using multivariate. Just substitute p equal to 2 and check if you get exactly the same form or not. Okay. Now, couple of why did I write bivariate here? Because there are some interesting insights over here. First thing, sigma 22.1 does not depend on the given value of y1. Same story happens in the multivariate case also. My variance is free from the given value. So in the conditional distribution in multivariate normal, conditional variance is not the function of the known value. Conditional mean is function of the known value, but conditional variance is not function of the known value. Okay, because in conditional mean you can see y1 here. So it is function of the conditioning value, but variance doesn't change. Another thing that I want to tell you is, see, sigma 22 into 1 minus rho square. Rho is going to be always between minus 1 and plus 1. So this factor is always between 0 and 1. Okay, because rho square will be between 0 and 1. So the difference will be between 0 and 1. So sigma 22.1 is going to be smaller than sigma 22. Because you are multiplying sigma 22 by a number which is between 0 and 1. So sigma 22.1 is always going to be smaller than sigma 22. It would be equal only if rho is 0. Okay. What does this mean? This means that the conditional variance is always less than the marginal variance. It makes sense because when you are computing conditional variance, you actually have some information about the other components. So that additional information decreases your variability. For example, in this case, if I know that height of a particular person is say 6 feet, then I know that weight cannot possibly, mostly the weight cannot be like in 30s or 30s or something. It has to be at least 40 kg. So the possible range for weight is lower once I know the height. Hence, variance, conditional variance is lower than the marginal variance. Another important point to be noticed about the distribution is this. Sigma 21 is covariance. Suppose covariance between x, y is positive. This is anyway variance, so this is going to be positive. So, I'm sorry, this is supposed to be mu 2. So, in that case, conditional mean of y2 is mu 2 plus this positive quantity into something. Now, this quantity can either be positive or negative. So, if suppose x1 is larger than mu 1, means the given value, y1. Given value of y, the given component is above average and the correlation is positive, covariance is positive, then the conditional mean is mu 2 plus some positive quantity. So the conditional mean is higher than the marginal mean. So if two components are positively correlated and if one of them has above average value, then the second one is also expected to have above average value. If instead this had been negative, then I would have mu 2 minus something. So if they are positively correlated but one of them has below average value, then the other component would also have below average value. For negative correlation, the result would be exactly opposite. And this is intuitively again correct, because that is your definition of correlation. Like the above average pairs tend to stay together and the below average pairs tend to stay together. So these are some of the interesting insights about the conditional distribution in the bivariate case. Similar thing can work in the multivariate case. Let us again go back to the regression setup. So in the regression setup, what I generally try to do is find conditional distribution of one variable using all the remaining components. Okay, so let me call y as say xp, then I'm trying to find distribution of y using x1, x2, xp minus 1. So this will again be univariate normal with mean mu p, the pth component, it's a scalar, mu p plus sigma 1 prime, sigma 1 1 inverse, and then x1 minus mu 1. And variance would be sigma pp dot 1, where sigma pp dot 1 is actually sigma pp minus sigma 1 prime, sigma 1 1 inverse, sigma 1, where sigma 1 is a covariance vector. So covariance of xp with others. This is a vector produced by computing covariance of xp with others. Okay, sigma 1. Now, this quantity, this is a quadratic form in sigma 1 1 inverse, we know that sigma 11 is positive definite. So sigma 11 inverse is also positive definite, and this is a quadratic form, so this will be positive. So this variance will also be always less than or equal to sigma pp. So the same story holds, that the conditional variance is always less than or equal to the marginal variance. And here also you can see that if all the covariances are positive, then whatever we talked about this works true. Okay, so here I will stop my discussion about conditional variances, conditional distribution. So try to derive all these things. First homework is deriving the conditional distribution using usual formula, joint PDF upon marginal PDF. Second homework is deriving this bivariate using the multivariate. Okay, let me stop here.